Hello and welcome to this video, in which I would like to exchange some lifetime with knowledge again. We really have to look at style and composition transfer here. I haven't done that on the channel yet, and that wasn't so bad, because there is still a lot going on in this area. And that's why I would like to start this video with a meaningful quote from Matteo, the developer of the IPAdapter nodes. He said, "We focus so much on developing the new techniques, trying them out without understanding the old ones at all." And from this concept, the style and composition transfer was also created. And what it does is, in principle, it only allows us to transfer the style or the composition of a picture to our picture. And composition is not this image-to-image thought, but really rough composition. So not creating a copy of the picture, but a new picture that is similar to the old one. But I think that will be a little clearer when we look at examples. Let's just start. So I loaded a basic workflow. Just down here, load default, my safe image node, so that I can put, you can see the correct sampler settings here. You are welcome to take over. I took a very simple prompt, namely only a cat and then detailed, intricate, sharp focus and a few negatives. Empty latent image is set to 1024 by 1024 because we are in the SDXL area. And as a model I took Fenris XL, simply because I noticed that it is pretty good with cats. So, and that fits our prompt. Okay, let's start the whole thing so that the checkpoint can be loaded. And in the meantime, I'll start. What we need is an IP adapter advanced. So, this we need to start. What we also need is a unified loader. Here I take out the plus model with high strength, connect the model to the loader, and from here to the IPA, and from there up to the sampler. Now we actually need a reference image. Let's take a load image node, and at the beginning I'll take this image from Indiana Jones. So we know that, we know what happens from the previous videos to the IP adapter, which is now relatively new. Here are different weight types. We have the style transfer, the composition, strong style transfer, style and composition, and style transfer precise. It's relatively new. Then came a few more developments, but we'll just go through all the possibilities in this video. Let's take a look at the style transfer. I'll press start and we'll let the whole picture render again. This is our reference image. I can also zoom in a bit so that we can see it better. That's pretty good with cats, Fenris. The denoising starts and we see that the style of our Indiana Jones image has already transferred very nicely to our cat image. And we also get a different stylized image in general. It's like this old Egypt style here. This is the normal style transfer. How does it work? Roughly speaking, I recommend watching Matteo's videos. He was able to go into a little more detail. Stable diffusion basically consists of 12 layers and each layer is responsible for a different functionality. Matteo succeeded in extracting the layers and finding out which layer is responsible for the style of an image and the other layer for the composition. The style is layer 6 and the composition is layer 3. We use this to be able to transfer not the complete image description, but only the stylistic description of an image. This is the style transfer. We'll get to the composition in a moment. We also have the strong style transfer. It's just stronger than the normal style transfer. But we also see here that not only the colors and the style of the image are transferred, but also other descriptions. We still have our cat, but still mixed with Indy and the individual characters that are still depicted here. If you want to avoid something like that, we can either go down with the weight. As you can see, we still have a humanoid cat, but now we have more cats than humans. Another variant is of course the time stepping. We say to the model up to 20%, the denoising belongs to you completely. Then our IP adapter mixes from 20% to 100%. Here the cat is created, now the IP adapter kicks in and now the style is transferred for the remaining steps of the denoising. And so we can achieve a significantly different representation than if we now have weight 1, a reduced weight, or use the time stepping here. So we go down here again. We still have the style transfer precise and it is relatively new and basically does the same, but the most beautiful. whereby the notes that I will show you in a moment, I think, will deliver even more beautiful results. But we go through all the possibilities here. So this is the result with the style transfer precise. Also very nicely implemented, as I think, very well done. Once briefly as an example next to it, we can choose Van Gogh here. I'll let that run through. So now we have a cat in Van Gogh style. You can see quite well, I think, the composition. We can do it again. I'll take the Mona Lisa up here and we'll take style and composition now. What style and composition does is it addresses both layers. So, as I just said, layer 3 for the composition and layer 6 for the style. In this case, both are addressed. That means the IP adapter is now looking at the composition of this image, which is a woman with crouched arms sitting in front of whatever. And at the same time also for the style layer, that it is a painting, the description of the colors, etc. And something like this comes out. If we want to mix the whole thing now, then we can do that too, by using two IP adapters. We chain the models, we take the same IP adapter from there, we pull the model up into the sampler, take a second load image node, and take Van Gogh here. Hang them in here like this and say down here, this is supposed to be our style and this up here is supposed to be our composition. And if I run that now, then we see that we have got a pretty good mix. On the one hand from our prompt, a cat, then from the composition of the picture of Mona Lisa and Van Gogh's style. Perhaps it is also important to know that the IPA takes a center square cropped from the middle. That means if you want to shift the focus of the IPA, you can still take the prep image for clip vision node and then say whether you want to use the image as a reference here, for example, top, bottom, center, left, right or whatever. Now for the examples here it is enough. However, you then have a warning in the console if the IPA recognizes a not cropped square image, then it automatically takes the middle of the image. So we have two IPAs here, we can throw them away. There are other variants, namely we can use the IP adapter style and composition SDXL. So I'll just hang it around here and here we can already see that we have image style and image composition here. So that's a more convenient way to use the construct from scratch. That means we can put the style back in there, we can put the composition in from up here. Since we have now changed the IPA anyway, I add a new IP adapter noise. So let's make it a little smaller. I put 0.8, 3 blur and shuffle. We take it as a negative image. You don't have to do that. That JSON doings we're sending in a slightly blurred noise as a negative example. And that's how the IPA or the unit recognizes it later. Blurred things are not desired. That's why he tries to render sharper at the same time. So I'll let it run. And here, too, we see that we get a very similar picture. Here we can still adjust the weight for the style and for the composition separately from each other. We can choose expand style again. This strengthens the transfer of the style a bit. But of course it also has an influence on our image generation. So that's basically the construct you can use if you don't want to work with two IPAs. Let's get rid of it. We have another option. And that's pretty brand new. There is now also the IP adapter precise style transfer. And here, too, we connect everything around again. This goes into the negative. And now we can choose a style again. Let's take India again. We take this style as an image up here. And weight 0.7 to 1 is quite okay. Style boost can be a little higher, like 1.5 to 3. I'll go up to 2 here. And now we can take a look at the precise style transfer. And that works really, really well. And I think the pictures that this node produces are a bit better than the others. Let's take the Mona Lisa style. Here, too, we get very nice pictures with the style back there. So with the painting style. Yes, we are not done yet, folk, there is another option. And now it's getting really crazy. And that's what the name of this node says, that's the Mad Scientist. It's really called Mad Scientist. And with this we can influence the generation of the layers ourselves. So, for example, I'll take Van Hall again. Hang that in. Take our negative. And let's take a look at this node. In principle, it is built up like a normal IP adapter. We can select weight types. We can specify different weights. Combine embeds, make timestamp the embed scale, that's all we had. But down here we have a text field with which we can address the 12 layers I just mentioned in a unit directly. And for the style transfer that would be a setting that looks like this. 3:2.5, 6:1. So 6:1. And we take the style transfer precise up here. What we're doing here with the Mad Scientist is a bit hacked in the case of the style transfer precise. Because, as I said, we can influence the individual strengths of each layer with this node. If you choose style transfer precise here, then this is not the strength of the layer itself, or not the strength of the conditioning, but of the unconditioning. That means we give the composition layer a stronger unconditioning at this point. With a value of 2.5, while the style layer remains at a weight of 1. And that's what this node does. If I run that now, then we see that we get pretty cool results by addressing the layers directly. For comparison, we take this style as a comparison. And then our cat looks like this now. So that the handling with this text box down here works a little better. I wrote a node for myself to test. You can also find it in my node collection. In the YANCs, link down below. It's called Layer Weights. Layer Weights for IPAMs. So IP Adapter Mad Scientist. We can just put them in there. And in principle, the same setting would be now if we say 2.5 and here 1. Then we would have made the same setting as before. But we can also do other things now. Which become a little crazier. I copy a Mad Scientist down. We connect the model once in a kind of chain. Hang the IP adapter in here. We also take the negative in here. We'll take a look at the pictures in a moment. But we still need a second node from here. Hang them in here once. And what we can do now is that we put both on linear. So put all layers on one up here first. I just do that. So. And down here all to 0. However, we can now go there and say, for example, we would like to have our Mona Lisa up here once. So. Although I can also crop them here. And that will be our reference picture for the upper IP adapter. And here we leave Indy and say that is the second. What we now have as a difference is that we do not only address layer 3 and 6, but because it is linear, we address all layers that the IP adapter would otherwise address. Set everything to what would be a normal IP adapter behavior. So send out picture and send out. But what we can do here now is we can say, take all layers of this picture except layer 6, which is responsible for the style. And down here, do not take a layer, also except layer 6. Oops. So, and by this, if I let that run now, we transfer with a linear setting. This picture, our entry picture. Over the IPA into the UNet, but only take the style from this picture. You can already see that the whole thing is a bit difficult to handle. This is due, for example, to the fact that you may have to adjust the weight a bit here. We are now just very granular here. But theoretically we could also say take everything from here except layer 3 and 6. Take from this picture only the style aka layer 6 and we hang a third picture with a third Mad Scientist underneath and say, but I would like to have the composition out of it. That's all about it. But that's such a thing. You have to get into it first, and find out the whole thing by testing and trying out which layer is responsible for what. Matteo has also opened a section for this. Of course, I can also put the link in the description, where the community is already trying to collect information. Which layer is responsible for what? I've seen fly by layers that may be more responsible for emotions that can be enhanced, or such stories. And that's why I made this node. So that it is a bit easier for us all to type weights per layer instead of typing in a text box. Yes, that was it, so it's not difficult. There are different ways to do it. Just try it out for yourself. I wish you a lot of fun playing around and experimenting around. See you in the next vid. Until then, take care and bye.